For single-engine aircraft, something as small as a bird can prove to be a real threat. And in one particular touch-and-go landing in a training session in the mid-2000s, the encounter was caught on camera. The nail-biting moment can be seen from the pilot's perspective in audio and video taken from the aircraft's heads-up display and later published in online forums. As the bird is ingested by the engine, it causes a cascading series of failures. The two pilots then try to restart the machine, but it's not turning on. Within a split second, the pilot starts pitching up, as if aiming for the best glide speed and trading off all the excess momentum for a little extra altitude before impact. At that moment, the two men must decide whether to try and save the aircraft or leave the stricken plane to its fate. Forum Wonder. A mid-2000s video captured through the aircraft heads-up display during an emergency crew ejection was published on military aviation forums and attracted heavy online traffic. The aircraft is being flown by a pilot instructor in the rear seat and a student in the front, and a bird suddenly flashes right before impacting the engine. The aircraft's voice warning system is immediately heard, telling the crew that they have a code T6NL problem.
T6NL.
Which indicates high temperatures, stage 6 severity, and low pressure. The engine was gone. The pilots then ran the emergency checklist and attempted to restart the engine many times. Both men can be heard breathing heavily, but they try to keep calm and assess the situation objectively.
Relay going.
Okay.
Get her from the front.
All right.
Fly the plane.
Okay.
With no way out, the senior pilot then tells the tower that he and his co-pilot are ejecting, and do so immediately after.
Ejected to the north, we have an engine failure.
Okay, prepared about an aircraft. Eject.
The video's last few seconds are chilling, as the recording continued after both ejections, but the tower didn't know it. As such, they continue giving confused feedback, unaware they're talking to an empty aircraft.
Viking at 2, copy your breakout to the north.
The jet dives right to the ground, and the natural laws of physics cause the doomed aircraft to quickly reach at least 175 miles per hour. In mere seconds, a farm plow row can be seen getting bigger and bigger until the aircraft crashes into it, far away from populated areas. In less than 60 seconds, a small animal costs the military millions of dollars and a huge scare for the ejected pilots. The footage was widely shared in internet forums in the mid-2000s. When it was first introduced, it was assumed the aircraft was a United States Air Force Lockheed Martin F-16 Fighting Falcon, the all-weather multi-role Wonder aircraft introduced in 1978. But not long after the video made its initial rounds, a new story about the true nature of the incident came to light. O Canada. Online commenters soon chimed in, and have since correctly identified the aircraft succumbing to a Seagull as a BAE Systems CT-155 Hawk trainer, belonging to the NATO Flying Training in Canada, or NFTC. At the time, the training jet with superior technology, capable of performing a wide range of high-performance missions, was being used to train pilots for frontline fighter aircraft. This fact was confirmed via specific visual and audio hints peppered throughout the video. First, as one user pointed out, the accents of the two men operating the aircraft were a mix of British and North American.
T6NL.
At the same time, the audio engine warnings were dispatched automatically in proper English pronunciation. According to Tim West, who at the time of the discovery worked for bird detection radar specialist D-Tech, the American Air Force F-16 Fighting Falcons are known to have audio alerts with a woman's voice, often referred to as Bitching Betty. On the other hand, the bird in question is seen entering the engine to the left of the screen, indicating an air intake on the starboard side of the fuselage, rather than the centrally mounted air intake of the F-16. This fact was pointed out by an ejection seat safety worker. To round out the online investigation, John Burnt, editor of the Texas branch newsletter of the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics Houston, as well as other enthusiasts, noted that the pilot tube is high up on the aircraft's nose, unlike the position of the one used in a standard F-16 cockpit. Nothing but the truth. On the heels of the online discussion, the Royal Canadian Air Force Directorate of Flight Safety confirmed that on May 14, 2004, a seagull was to blame for the unfortunate incident to one of their own aircraft. This came with the publication of an incident report. The online aficionados were correct, as the jet that struck the plane and was therefore sucked into the engine was indeed a CT-155 Hawk trainer. According to the report, the crew was conducting low-altitude flights as, quote, part of a navigation trip and part of a conversion syllabus designed to familiarize a prospective RAF student with the NFTC Hawk variant. Just before the incident, the instructor, Captain John Hutt from the Royal Canadian Air Force, had just taken control of his pupil, Royal Air Force Flight Lieutenant Edward Morris. The report described how, just as the aircraft approached the departure end of the runway, a bird was suddenly observed left off its nose, got sucked in, and caused the trainer to suffer a massive engine failure. With no way out, the teacher and pupil pilots managed to eject moments before the aircraft hit a plowed field, causing the trainer's camera to stop recording. The airspeed indicator showed that right before impact, the aircraft was going at 430 kilometers per hour, roughly 270 miles per hour, and that the incident took only 45 seconds from bird strike to ejection. According to a report, the aircraft landed north of 15 Wing Moose Jaw, a Canadian Forces base in Saskatchewan. As a result of the forced ejection, Hutt broke a few bones, but recovered quickly, and the student, Ed Morris of Great Britain, suffered minor injuries. Changes. The incident over the Canadian airspace transcended far beyond cyberspace, and the seagull may just as well have saved several lives. The trainer crash highlighted significant flaws in the aircrew life support equipment, and several changes have since been successfully introduced into the Royal Air Force. The NATO Flying Training in Canada program, to which the CT-155 Hawk belonged, was initially provided by the Military Aviation Training Division of Bombardier Aerospace before being transferred to Canadian Aviation Electronics Limited, a private company, by acquisition in 2015. Since the incident, there have been talks about replacing the Hawk with a new training program. As of 2021, the replacement program is known as the Future Aircrew Training Program, or FACT. Meanwhile, birds have always been and remain a significant threat to flight safety, and have caused a considerable amount of accidents, some with fatal consequences. According to official statistics, an average of 13,000 bird strikes are recorded annually in the United States alone, with military aircraft often being the more significant contributor, as accidents involving civil aircraft are pretty uncommon. And even though the mysterious backstory of the bird intake video was confirmed to be a Canadian CT-155 Hawk, the video continues to be shared with the title F-16 Bird Strike all around the internet. Thank you for watching Dark Footage. For more incredible videos and the real stories behind them, check out the rest of our content and also subscribe to our other Dark Documentaries channels where we publish regularly. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to be the first to know about all our newest videos. Stay tuned.